Hi guys, this is a video on the introduction to the Victorian age with special reference to fiction, prose and drama. You see a house here in the first slide. Why? Because in his preface to the Portrait of a Lady, Henry James, a very major Victorian writer, compares fiction to a house of vast proportions. He says, the house of fiction has in short not one window, but a million. The house of fiction has in short not one window, but a million. Now, the genres of the Victorian novel. The novel was the predominant genre of the Victorian period. And within the novel, there were many genres. Before we come to that, let me tell you briefly about the other genres. Autobiography was an important genre. Victorian autobiography. Many Victorian writers wrote autobiographies and biographies also. Autobiography was also the mode of Victorian novel. Many Victorian novels appeared as pseudo-autobiographies, including Jane Eyre. Melodrama was also a very important genre in Victorian drama. It was Oscar Wilde and George Bernard Shaw who saved the Victorian stage from melodrama. Satire and comic operas of Gilbert and Sullivan. The essay, the Victorian essay. And art and literary criticism. All of these we will talk about in the present video. Now, let me talk about one by one all these genres. The Victorian novel first. The Victorian novel included idealized portraits of difficult lives. The Victorian novel talked about hardworking people, idealized portraits of difficult lives. How hardworking rural people, especially like in Hardy, resist temptation and they struggle against fate. How love and luck win in the end. How poetic justice is meted out to the characters. Can you think of Victorian novels that are examples for all this? Hemlata Bhatt, Kishore Shinde, Divya Ajay. Can you think of Victorian novels where hardworking people's lives are depicted? Please post in the comments in YouTube answers to these questions. Also from Tess, Ritu Prince, Benisha, Polly, Arias. Now, the Victorian novel included skepticism, pessimism. Many Victorian novels showed skeptical, pessimistic attitudes vis-a-vis prosperity and optimism. On the one hand, there is prosperity and optimism. On the other hand, there is also skepticism and pessimism. Realism and naturalism flourished at this time. Realism means lifelike depictions of real life in the society. Realism gave way to naturalism. Naturalism gave a depiction of characters, human beings, as products of their environment. Human beings behave in certain ways because of their environment or situations. That is naturalism. Can you think of some naturalist novels? Can you give names of some naturalist novels? Sansa, Tirtha, Nitya from Tess, and Priyanka Soni, Prajwal, Harita Gopal. Give names of naturalist novels in the comments section. Novels in the Victorian period were serialized. Most of the novels in the Victorian period were serially published, serialized. And these novels also usually had the three-volume structure. When they were published in book form, the serialized novels had the three-volume structure. And novels were popular in nature. That means They had the features of popular fiction. What are the features of popular fiction? Shrisha, Gopika Murali, Manoj from Tess, Pooja, can you talk about what are the features of popular fiction? Now, the novels, the genres of novels included sensation novels. Wilkie Collins was a very major writer of sensation novels. Sensation novels gave way to detective fiction. Wilkie Collins wrote sensation novels like The Woman in White and The Moonstone. And detective fiction included the novels of Arthur Conan Doyle and Bram Stoker. Indu, Shaheen, Shraddha Pandey, Steffi Antony, please talk in the comment section on the features of sensation novels. What are sensation novels? Remember, Wilkie Collins wrote sensation novels. Fantasy novel, sensation novel, detective novel, all these originated in the Victorian period. The Victorian novel also was concerned with history, society, economics, philosophy. Ranjit Babu, Chitra Chandran, Anne Sharon, Mithuna from Tess. Can you name some history novels, historical novels of the Victorian period? Post in YouTube comment section, okay? Which are the novels that dealt with society? Can you find examples from George Meredith or George Eliot or Charles Dickens? Please post in the comment section. There was also writing for children. Many writers emerged at this time, children's writers. Lewis Carroll, R.M. Ballantyne, Anna Sewell. Do you know the names of the books of these writers? Lewis Carroll wrote Alice in Wonderland. R.M. Ballantyne wrote The Coral Island. Which is the novel based on The Coral Island? Somebody post in comment section. Which is the novel based on Coral Island? Anna Sewell, what did she write? Black Beauty. R.L. Stevenson, Kidnapped and Treasure Island. Thomas Hughes wrote, what did he write? Muscular novel. Thomas Hughes's novel is a muscular novel. Tom Brown's School Days. Rudyard Kipling wrote Jungle Book. So, Devjani, Kavita Pandey, Humaira, Krishnapriya, please write the list of all the books written by these writers in the comment section. Now, the major genres and of the novel we just talked about. Now, the major trends or movements in the Victorian period. There was the social novel or the Condition of England novel. Social novel is also called Condition of England novel or industrial novel. Devagi, Renuga, Tanuja, Rinuja from Tess, please post in the comment section names of social novels. The social novel or Condition of England novel or industrial novel. The woman question. What is the woman question? How to deal with the women who wanted liberation at this time? Steffi Antony has said she understands Irish question and woman question. Others, look up what is woman question. Women wanted liberation at this time. They wanted to wear better clothes at this time. They wanted education. All this led to the new woman, the image of the new woman in fiction at this time. The woman question. Can you, Parvati and Annie from Tess, can you post names of new women novels in the comment section? New women novels. Also place. Now, utilitarianism was a very important movement of this time. We'll deal with all this in detail. Darwinism, Oxford movement, positivism, aestheticism, silver fork fiction, Newgate fiction. All these are the important genres of the Victorian period. Now, Some of you please post what are the novels that come under silver fork fiction. Rabia, Rebecca, Sarah Ali, Rasia. Please type in the comment section examples for silver fork fiction. And then Newgate fiction. Habib, Sanjay Mondal, Firoz, Manu PM. I want you to type names of Newgate fiction. Will you do that? Okay, let us talk about these genres and movements in detail. The social novel means realistic portrayal of social life. Realistic portrayal of social life. The social novel arose in the 1830s and 40s. As a reaction to the socio-economic upheavals following the Reform Act of 1832. Shweta Garg, Mohan Kumar, Gaurav, Debjani. Do you remember who died in 1832? Who died in 1832? Can you type? The social novel arose in the 1830s and 40s. And it was a reaction to the socio-economic upheavals following the Reform Act. After the Reform Act, a lot of good things happened, but a lot of people got confused and upset. There were lots of upheavals after this. And this led to the genre social novel. It was against rapid industrialization. It was against the abuses of the government and factory owners. Novels like Oliver Twist, which was against the rise of capitalism and bourgeois culture. It talked about the working classes, depicted the sufferings of the poor, and the social novel or industrial novel or Condition of England novel, it came to be called. Now, Condition of England was a phrase used by Thomas Carlyle in Chartism. Subita, Samita, Amrita from Tess, please post some works of Thomas Carlyle in the comment section, okay? Don't fail to do it. Post names of works of Thomas Carlyle. Thomas Carlyle's one work is called Chartism, 1839. 20 years before what? Origin of Species. What is Chartism? Chartism was a working class political reformist movement that sought universal male suffrage and other parliamentary reforms. They wanted voting rights for all men. That is called universal male suffrage. Condition of England novels were named after a phrase that Carlyle used in Chartism. Condition of England novels considered the question of how to resolve the tension between the new working classes and the owners. Now, Elizabeth Barrett Browning's poem, The Cry of the Children, portrays the suffering of the children in mines and factories. That is a Condition of England poem. Elizabeth Barrett Browning's poem, The Cry of the Children. Will you read it now? Will you read The Cry of the Children? Olivia Mariam Francis, Harish, Jairaj, Deepa Elizabeth Thomas, Anjali Anand. Will one of you post The Cry of the Children poem in the comment section of YouTube? Please post The Cry of the Children poem in the comment section, okay? Anybody from YouTube also can do. Indu, Debjani, you can do. So, Elizabeth Barrett Browning's poem, The Cry of the Children, is Condition of England poem. Friedrich Engels, do you know who that is? Friedrich Engels is the companion of Karl Marx. Friedrich Engels and Karl Marx together wrote the Communist Manifesto in 1848. 3 years before that, Friedrich Engels wrote The Condition of the Working Class. It was written after he spent 20 months observing industrial conditions in Manchester. Engels came and lived in Manchester. Rasia, did you know that? He came and lived in Manchester, observed industrial conditions in Manchester and wrote about it. And this book, The Condition of the Working Class, later led to the Communist Manifesto also. More Condition of England novels are Francis Trollope's Michael Armstrong, The Factory Boy, Benjamin Disraeli's Sybil or the Two Nations, Elizabeth Gaskell's Mary Barton, Charlotte Bronte's Shirley, Charles Kingsley's Alton Locke, and Charles Dickens's Hard Times. Rebecca, Ranveer Singh, Muhammad Amin, Prakash Mohanty, Prajwal, will one of you post more details of these novels, at least the name of protagonist or something? Prajwal, I expect you to do it, okay? One of you should do it. Francis Trollope's Michael Armstrong, The Factory Boy. Benjamin Disraeli's Sybil or The Two Nations. They might ask questions on all this. Elizabeth Gaskell's Mary Barton, A Tale of Manchester Life. That is the subtitle. Charlotte Bronte's Shirley. Charles Kingsley's Alton Locke. Charles Dickens's Hard Times. All these works depict the harshness of existence in the industrial towns through the fictional city of Coketown. Not all these novels. The Hard Times depicts the harshness of existence in the industrial towns through the fictional city of Coketown. Hard Times is the only novel by Dickens which is not set in London. Hard Times. Prajwal, please post details or any of the other people I called, okay? Now, the woman question. Steffi, once again, look at the woman question. The woman question raised by Mary Wollstonecraft was in her pamphlet, A Vindication of the Rights of Woman. Renuga, what was it a reply to? It was a reply to anybody? Sharad Kumar, Toms? A Vindication of the Rights of Woman was a reply to Edmund Burke's Reflections on the Revolution in France. Edmund Burke criticized the French revolutionaries in Reflections on the Revolution in France. And Thomas Paine wrote a reply to it in Rights of Man. Mary Wollstonecraft wrote a reply in A Vindication of the Rights of Woman. Will you remember? Now, these early feminists urged upper class women to obtain proper education and profession in order to make themselves financially independent. This is the society's woman question, because there were early feminists at this time who were urging women to be independent. Nilesh Rathor, this is called woman question. The novelists Francis Trollope and Elizabeth Gaskell urged upper class women to become active in the public sphere. Charlotte Bronte and George Eliot criticized the social marginalization of women. Nilesh Rathor, Suchita Joshi, Shweta Garg, Divya, Deeksha Kajal. One of you, can you post all the heroines of Charlotte Bronte and George Eliot. Heroines of Charlotte Bronte and George Eliot list. Can you post in comment section? Heroines of Charlotte Bronte and George Eliot. Please post. The New Woman was a term coined by Sarah Grant in 1894. The New Woman, term coined by Sarah Grant. Akshaya and Charumati, will you remember? The New Woman was a cultural icon of the Findi Circle. Circle. Findi Circle. A departure from the stereotypical Victorian woman. Victorian woman was a stereotype. Prim and proper, she doesn't challenge patriarchy. The New Woman was a departure from the ideal of the Victorian woman. The New Woman is intelligent, educated, emancipated, independent and self-supporting. She is a liberated woman. Can you give a list of new women in fiction or literature? Charumati and Akshaya, right? Shivalakshmi also, please post in the comment section. List of new women in literature. The New Woman is not only middle class, but also factory and office workers. The New Woman expressed dissatisfaction with the contemporary position of women in marriage and society. The New Woman expressed dissatisfaction with the contemporary position of women in marriage. In marriage, women are oppressed. In society, women are oppressed. That is what the New Woman writers felt. And New Woman novels are where heroines fight against the perception of woman as an angel in the house. Harita Gopal, who created the concept of angel in the house, please post in the comment section. And they challenge the old codes of conduct and morality. The new woman novels challenge the old codes of conduct and morality. They deal frankly with sex and marriage, as well as women's desire for independence and fulfillment. The new women writers indicated three major areas in which women felt oppressed: marriage, labor market, and suffrage. They talked about three areas in which women were feeling oppressed. What are the three areas? Marriage, labor market, and suffrage. Conventional marriage is viewed as a degrading and oppressive institution because women suffered inferior status within conventional marriage and were often victims of domestic violence. So new women novels were against conventional marriage. Olive Schreiner's Story of an African Farm. Crystal Jasmine, have you heard this? Olive Schreiner's Story of an African Farm. It's a feminist Bildungsroman. An assertive heroine who can shape her life is the protagonist. And here, she also deals with sexual initiation, premarital sex, free thinking, gender identity, rejection of marriage, etc. Sarah Grant, George Egerton, other writers, the new women novelists criticized the representations of ideal womanhood. Divya Pais and Diya Saji, are you paying attention? The new women novels criticized the representations of ideal womanhood. What are the ideal women in fiction? Amelia Sedley in Vanity Fair, Esther Summerson in Bleak House, Krishna R.M., Jyoti V., Greetwin, Neeraj from Tess, Ram Singh, Sajin Saheb. Can one of you post more details of Vanity Fair and Bleak House and the women here? Amelia Sedley, Esther Summerson, please post more details in comment section. And the new women novelists criticized representations of ideal womanhood. They created bold, independent female characters modeled on new women, such as Charlotte Bronte's Shirley, it is a new woman. Elizabeth Gaskell's Margaret Hale is a new woman. Margaret Hale is from which novel? From which novel is Margaret Hale? You should find out and post. It is, I won't tell you. Dash and Dash. That is the title. Dash and Dash. Okay? Then there are also novelists like George Meredith. George Meredith wrote Diana of the Crossways, published in 1885. Diana of the Crossways is about a passionate and intelligent upper class young woman who is trapped in an abusive marriage. Diana, the protagonist, is a passionate, independent, upper-class woman trapped in an abusive marriage. George Gissing's Odd Women is a novel published in 1893, focuses on the fates of young single women and shows that the patriarchal society is unable to accept the increasing presence of new independent women in the public sphere. George Gissing's Odd Women focuses on the fates of single women and shows that the patriarchal society is unable to accept the increasing presence of new women in public sphere. Grant Allen wrote The Woman Who Did, 1895. 1895 is a momentous year. It was the year in which Importance of Being Earnest was published as well. Grant Allen's The Woman Who Did combines free love theme with an anti-marriage message. The Cambridge-educated heroine of the novel refuses to marry her lover. The Cambridge-educated heroine refuses to marry her lover. And what does she do? She gives birth to an illegitimate daughter without marrying. That is something that people, women won't dare to do even now. If you get pregnant, you marry your lover. That is what the society expects women to do. But in 1895, here is a woman character who is giving birth to a daughter without marriage, refusing to marry her lover. Wow. Margaret Atwood has also written a novel of the same. Margaret Drabble has also written a novel of the same theme. Deb Jani, Kavita Pandey, Krishna Priya, Harita Gopal, Can one of you post the name of Margaret Drabble's novel where a woman gets pregnant and she chooses to bring up her illegitimate child? The New Woman was also created by Thomas Hardy. Thomas Hardy praised the New Woman writers, created a memorable and tragic female character in his last novel, Jude the Obscure. Who is that character? Who is the protagonist of Jude the Obscure? Hemalada Bhatt, Priyanka Soni. You have to tell me. You have to write in the comment section, Tribhuvan. Who is the new woman heroine of our Jude the Obscure? It is there in the slide. But you post in the comment section. Sue Brighthead, an enlightened liberal new woman, is the victim of oppressive Victorian and moral double standards. Like the new woman female authors, Hardy also objects to the Victorian view of the sacredness of the institution of marriage. The sacredness of the institution of marriage is questioned by Hardy in at least two novels. Vijay Kumar Rathod, do you know which are the two novels which question the institution of marriage? Now, in Jude, Hardy proposes the abolition of conventional marriage because it is not in harmony with human nature. Now, utilitarianism. Utilitarianism is an important movement of the Victorian period. Let us talk about that. Utilitarianism is the idea that the moral worth of an action is determined solely by its contribution to overall unity. If something contributes to overall utility, not unity, utility, if something is useful for maximum number of people, then even if it is immoral, it is okay. That is the meaning. Did you understand Arindam Banerjee? If something is useful for a large number of people, then even if it's immoral, it is okay. We'll consider it as moral. Utilitarianism is the idea that the moral worth of an action is determined solely by its contribution to overall utility. That is, its contribution to happiness or pleasure as summed among all people. Shriraag, Shridhar, can you post the names of some works that are anti-utilitarian in the comment section? Please post some works that are anti-utilitarian. Utilitarianism is a form of consequentialism, meaning that the moral worth of an action is determined by its outcome. Utilitarianism is a part of another philosophical idea called consequentialism. What is consequentialism? Consequentialism is the idea that moral worth of an action is determined by its outcome. And utilitarianism is part of this. The origins of utilitarianism are often traced as far back as the Greek philosopher Epicurus. The Greek philosopher Epicurus, who is associated with Epicureanism, is often considered to be the originator of utilitarianism. And in modern times, it is credited to Jeremy Bentham, the 17th century philosopher. Jeremy Bentham proposed many legal and social reforms. He was a reformer in many, many ways. He expounded an underlying moral principle on which they should be based, he also created a utilitarian code of law called panomian. He propounded the greatest happiness principle. He said all poetry is misrepresentation. All poetry is exaggeration or misrepresentation. All these things are attributed to Jeremy Bentham. This is Jeremy Bentham. He is the man who also started utilitarianism. Bentham's foremost proponent in the 19th century was James Mill. a significant philosopher in his day and the father of John Stuart Mill. J.S. Mill's father, James Mill. The younger Mill was educated according to Bentham's principles. The younger Mill means J.S. Mill was educated according to Bentham's principles. Have you heard of Jeremy Bentham, J.S. Mill, Habib Ali? Please post some works of J.S. Mill in the comments. Will you, Habib? Please post some works of J.S. Mill in the comment section. The younger Mill, that is J.S. Mill, was educated according to Bentham's principles, including transcribing and summarizing much of his father's work. James Mill's work, J.S. Mill summarized. And J.S. Mill formed the Utilitarian Society. J.S. Mill formed the Utilitarian Society. It became a very controversial movement. It was founded in 1823. I think that is the year in which Essays of Elia was published. Was it Shrisha Shivadas? Can you post details of Essays of Elia in the comment section, Shrisha? Now, John Stuart Mill. This is John Stuart Mill. Utilitarianism is described by the phrase, the greatest happiness of the greatest number is the only right and proper end of government. That is the definition. The greatest happiness of the greatest number is the only right and proper end of the government. Bentham understood happiness to be pleasure as against pain. Happiness is a kind of higher pleasure. The greatest happiness of the greatest number. Now, why am I posting videos in YouTube? Because it's a utilitarian mentality. That means the greatest happiness of the greatest number. A lot of you should be happy. You should benefit from it. You will be happy if you are able to study well. So I'm trying to give you some happiness through these videos. Are you getting happiness? If you are getting happiness, please post in the comment section. Okay? Right. It has been criticized. Utilitarianism has also been criticized as a quantitative and reductionist approach to ethics. Utilitarianism has been criticized as a quantitative and reductionist approach to ethics. That means it supports unethical or immoral things also. Utilitarianism has been criticized because it sometimes supports immoral things. And J.S. Mill defended Bentham. J.S. Mill defended Jeremy Bentham with his qualitative categorization of pleasure. Pleasure should be of a higher quality. Anything is not pleasure. Pleasure of the body is not pleasure. Pleasure is a higher emotion. He qualitatively distinguished pleasure as something higher. And look at J.S. Mill in his famous short work, Utilitarianism. J.S. Mill argues that cultural, intellectual, and spiritual pleasures are of greater value than mere physical pleasure. He argues that cultural, intellectual, and spiritual pleasures are of greater value than physical pleasures. Did you understand? It is better to be a human dissatisfied than a pig satisfied. It is better to be a human dissatisfied than a human satisfied. It is better to be Socrates dissatisfied than a fool satisfied. A fool will be easily satisfied. A fool will be easily satisfied. But Socrates will never be satisfied. Which is better, to be Socrates or fool? To be Socrates. This quote demonstrates Mill's distinction between higher and lower pleasures and defends Bentham and his father in their focus on happiness. His father means James Mill. Major works of J.S. Mill. Habib, assignment is done here. What is poetry? On liberty, utilitarianism, the subjection of women, on social freedom. On social freedom. Please post all these in the comments, Habib. Attitude to social reform. The utilitarians supported reforms to improve conditions for the lower classes. The utilitarians supported factory reforms. They wanted to improve conditions for the lower classes. and they supported Adam Smith's concept of free trade. If more workers are happy, more successful an industry be, and all the export import should be free, it should not be controlled by the government. These are the major ideas of utilitarianism that supported society. But why was it criticized? Because it gave too much importance to reason. It gave too much importance to reason. People criticized it. Who are the people who criticized it? Dickens and Carlyle. Okay. Thomas Carlyle and Charles Dickens were among the most vocal in opposing utilitarian thinking. Carlyle and Dickens very vehemently opposed utilitarian thinking. In Signs of the Times by Carlyle, what does he do? He criticizes the utilitarian belief that happiness depends on external circumstances. Happiness depends on external circumstances. He criticizes this idea. In Hard Times, which is dedicated to Carlyle, why is it dedicated to Carlyle? Because both of them are criticizing utilitarianism. In Hard Times, which is dedicated to Carlyle, Dickens attacks the utilitarian theories of society and education and shows the abuse of utilitarianism. Did you understand? He attacks utilitarian theories. Vijay Kumar Rathod, Nazia, Anjali Sugathan, Pappi Hari, then who else? Yogesh. Will you please post details of Hard Times in the comment section? Okay. Now, Oxford Movement is next. Oxford Movement was an affiliation of High Church Anglicans. Most of them were members of the University of Oxford. It was an affiliation of High Church Anglicans. That means one kind of Anglicans. They sought to reform the Anglican Church to demonstrate that the Church of England was a direct descendant of the Church established by the apostles. They wanted to show that Church of England is great, and they wanted to reform Church of England. And they wanted to establish that Anglican Church is actually a branch of the Catholic Church. The Oxford Movement was criticized as Tractarian movement. It was not a respectful word. They criticized Oxford Movement as Tractarian movement or Tractarianism after its series of publications called Tracts for the Times, 1833 to 1841. Cardinal Newman was an important figure. The Tractarians were also called Newmanites and Puseyites in a very negative way. They were called Newmanites and Puseyites after the two prominent Tractarians, Edward Bovary Pusey and Cardinal John Henry Newman. John Henry Newman was canonized in 1991. Apologia Pro Vita Sua, that was his autobiography. Then Grammar of Ascent, The Dream of Gerontius, The Idea of a University, the popular hymn Lead Kindly Light. These are all works by Cardinal John Henry Newman. People from Testara, Gopika Murali, Pujas, Aryas, both of you. Pujas, both of you, Aryas, Remya RG. Can some of you post the works of Cardinal Newman in the comment section? This is Cardinal Newman. Painting by John Everett Millais. Pre-Raphaelite, remember? John Everett Millais. Now. Even before Charles Darwin published his Origin of Species by Means of Natural Selection, that is the full title, that was in 1859. He also published Descent of Man, that is in 1871. Even before this, the debate over evolution had been developing throughout the 19th century. In Origin of Species, Darwin explained evolution as the natural selection of species with specialized traits, or otherwise called survival of the fittest. In Descent of Man, Darwin proposed that man descended from primates. This is Charles Darwin. Darwin's theories provoked in Victorian literature a wave of pessimism and skepticism about the human condition. Till then, all theories of the world had put mankind in a superior position. Darwinism appealed to scientists like Thomas Henry Huxley, as well as to novelists and poets. Two pre-1859 poems reflecting evolutionary theory and the crisis of faith are Tennyson's In Memoriam and Arnold's Dover Beach. In Elizabeth Gaskell's last novel, Wives and Daughters, the naturalist hero Roger Hamley, that is in Wives and Daughters by Elizabeth Gaskell. North and South, that is another novel by Elizabeth Gaskell, where Margaret Hale is the protagonist. I told you that earlier. I did not tell you actually. I said dash and dash. Now, Elizabeth Gaskell wrote Wives and Daughters, where there is a character, Roger Hamley, modeled on Charles Darwin. You know, Elizabeth Gaskell and Charles Darwin were cousins. George Eliot wrote Middlemarch, which is regarded as a demonstration of Darwinism. Hardy's Tess and Jude the Obscure present a Darwinian world where the characters are at the mercy of their environment. Darwinian world. Now, positivism is developed by the French philosopher Auguste Comte. French philosopher he is. Did you understand Sanjuti Jay, Lakshmi Radha, Archana SK, Rini Linesh? Positivism. It's a form of empiricism. Empiricism means what? Belief in experience. Every rational assertion can be scientifically verified. That is the meaning of positivism. Every rational assertion can be scientifically verified. It regards metaphysical speculations as meaningless. Sense perceptions are the only source of knowledge. It reflected the general tone of Victorian social optimism. And it was advocated by Victorians like J.S. Mill, Herbert Spencer, George Henry Lewis, etc. Positivism was advocated by Victorian writers also. Aestheticism rejected John Ruskin's and Matthew Arnold's utilitarian view of art. Hey, pay attention, everyone. John Ruskin and Matthew Arnold both believed in art for life's sake. That is a utilitarian view of art. John Ruskin and Matthew Arnold believed in a utilitarian view of art as something moral and useful. Aestheticism rejected this. John Ruskin and Matthew Arnold believed that art is useful. Art for life's sake. John Ruskin and Matthew Arnold believed in art for life's sake. Aestheticism rejected it. Aestheticism is related to decadence, symbolism, fin de siècle writers. It upheld the motto, art for art's sake. What is the French for art's sake? Do you know the French word for art's sake? Ranjit, Manoj, Shankar, Rajesh Kumar Yadav. One of you from TESS, Nagendra, please post. Now, aestheticism developed a cult for beauty. Walter Pater, Oscar Wilde, A.C. Swinburne were important figures. Walter Pater, Oscar Wilde, A.C. Swinburne. So, aestheticism, with that, I come to the end of the introduction to Victorian fiction, prose, drama. Next video will be on Charles Dickens.